I just want to take a moment and say thank you for everything that you've done for me and this program over the last 4.5 years. You and I, we've been a team together for 3 consecutive years, and I am so thankful for all the memories that we've shared and the friendship that we've built over those years. You know, we've laughed until we've cried. We've also cried. We've sang Disney tunes to the top of our lungs. We've done it all, and those are memories that you don't ever forget, and I know I won't. And I know that I'll cherish them forever. Clayton, you are such a considerate person. You have this way of making people feel comfortable around you, which I think is really, really special. For me, you know, coming into the program, I was a little apprehensive, and I was afraid that I wouldn't be accepted by, you know, other people who didn't share my values and religious beliefs. And you were actually one of the first people who, you know, asked me about my faith and asked me about myself and expressed interest in it and made me feel welcome and accepted and loved. And I'm thank you so much for that. I also want to say thank you for being an incredible captain this fall. I know that we never got around to making a Claytini, but I think Team Claytini owes you a lot for all of your work this fall. Thank you for giving me guidance, but also giving me the freedom to grow as a leader and to make decisions. And I think that I've become a stronger leader because of that. And with that, we just want to say thank you again. Goodbye. You will be missed so much. And we love you, and don't be a stranger. Bye, Clayton.
I didn't think there was anyone else in mock trial with my particular brand of nerdiness. But it's really fun getting to ride with you, especially up to Classic City. We talked about everything from Buffy to boys to travel and everything in between. I've always felt really comfortable around you. I think one of the greatest parts of your personality is your ability to make people feel included. And I wanted to say thank you so much. I really enjoyed that aspect of you, especially at mock trial gatherings. So thank you for making my junior year so special. You are truly a great mocker. I have never seen anyone else pour so much of themselves into their characters. You will be missed, and I hope you come back and visit us.
Drive a roll at the partition, please. Drop a roll at the partition, please. I don't need you seeing your say on her knees. To 45 minutes to get...
Hi, Narky. I'm so happy I get to talk about you for a moment on video. So this is what I have to say. You're leaving a truly amazing footprint on the mock trial community. On a personal level, you're a great friend, and you're just a scintillating conversationalist. You've made the best companion on road trips and in my passenger seat to always have the most interesting things to talk about, and I'm going to miss your bear hugs, etc. I really gave my chiropractor a lot to work on there. But on a more serious note, in the mock trial community, you've been an amazing witness and attorney. You've really had a very special presence. You've had enviable dedication that everybody really could hope to match. Just your passion for the details of the case and for the details of the mock trial community in general, where you have really supernatural networking skills. You're able to pick up the name of every single person in the room, and everybody knows you. You've become really a personality and a presence in the community that is to be reckoned with. So you're going to leave a big spot in everybody's hearts when you leave, and I know that I speak on behalf of everybody when I say that you will be dearly missed. So, thank you.
I am so excited that I get to talk about you because for the longest time you have been such a big influence in this program. You have been our biggest support, our biggest cheerleader, and one of our closest friends. And you have been a friend to every single person in this program, and you've gone above and beyond for us. And you went above and beyond for me in freshman year. My freshman year formal, I was ditched by my date 15 minutes before we were supposed to leave, and I was a wreck. My hair was a mess, my makeup was a mess, but I called Corey, and through a mess of tears and begging, he, without any reservations or without asking any questions, put on a suit and took me to my very first formal, and we had a blast. And it was the most wonderful thing that anyone has ever done for me. But in reality, that's just who Corey is. Corey is there when you need him. He'll take you to Ben and Jerry's Free Cone Day. He'll wear the same red UGA hat no matter the occasion or how formal we're supposed to be. And he's a great friend. And he's the real life incarnation of Ted, Evelyn, Mosby. And everything that he does is legend, wait for it, dairy. Hey, Corey, I'm so excited for everything that you're going to be doing in life. But don't forget about us back in Athens. You are the bomb, and see you later, Mr. Anderson.
Get jazzy on. I'm that flight that you get on. International. First class seat on my
lap. Hi, Johanna, it's me. I really can't believe you're graduating. I don't know what I'm going to do without you next year. Just know that I'm going to be in New York all the time this summer. I'm going to miss you a lot. I just wanted to tell you that you're somebody that I've grown to admire so much. You're a beautiful girl inside and out, and you mean the world to me. I'm sad to see you go, but I'm so glad that I had the opportunity to get close to you this year and last year. And I wish you the best of luck in the future. Like I said, I'm going to be there as much as I possibly can, and I hope that you're back to visit all the time. I'm going to miss you so much. And I really don't know what Olivia Pope and Associates is going to do without Olivia Pope.
English. Our conversations ain't long, but you know what is.
Dancing through life, mindless and careless. Make sure you wear less. Trouble is rife. Woes are fleeting, blows are
glass. Ashley, you were one of the first people that I met on mock trial, and you were also one of the very few veterans among all of the lovely ladies of Team 1431. And because of that, I respected you as a teacher almost immediately. But there are some experiences that you can't help but be friends after going through, and dodging 9.5 deer on a stretch of road that could only be described as Canyon Road on the way back from FSU, the year we tried the Dawson case, is definitely one of them. Since then, I haven't gotten to be on your team as much as I'd like, but I have gotten you to watch you triumph over objection battles. I got to watch you play your very first witness, although I'm sorry it had to be Haley Floyd. And we've bonded over BBC, Joss Whedon, and being the random girl messing with yarn in the back of the room. And I'm just so glad that you've gotten to be a part of my life for the last 3 years. You are smart and talented and determined, and those are the characteristics that have served you so well in this program, and I know they're the ones that are going to serve you well as you move through law school and beyond. Mercer is really lucky to have you, and I think I speak for the entire program when I say we're all cheering you on. Good luck, and we will miss you next year.
Hey Mindy, it's Julie, but you probably knew that already. I'm so sad I can't be there to say our official goodbyes tonight, but thankfully I get to leave you this video instead. Mindy Johnson. It takes someone very special to be able to do this with, and this with. Oh, Mindy, these past 3 years with you have been so incredible, and I couldn't have asked for a better teammate and friend. You're so intelligent, kind, beautiful, and talented, and I can't wait to see you take the world by storm. And on that note, I'll miss you very, very much. Have the best night ever. Go get wasted and celebrate your accomplishments, and I love you very much, and I'm so proud of everything that you've done.
Hey, Blue Eyes. I know there may have been some times this year where I've been standing closer to Mindy. We might have made fun of you. But I just want you to know that I've never forgotten the times that we had together. Those times in bed at the tournament weekends, before Hannah showed up. Those times at counsel table, before Mindy sat down. I'm sensing a theme here that the boys' dance party knows how to have a good time. It's been great being a founding member of boys' dance party with you, otherwise living in the shadow of the great Jacob Edwards, the top-ranking UJ mock trial attorney, perjury celebrity. But in all seriousness, I know that we couldn't have done what we did this year without you. I really appreciate all of the time and the effort that you put into our team, all the time that you sacrificed hanging out with your real friends. And I know that we absolutely couldn't have gotten where we did without all your help. Happy to know that we'll still have you around next year. Huge congrats on committing to UGA Law and to committing to judging all four rounds of Classic City. I would say that you'll be missed next year, but I know we'll still have you around. See you around. Long live the walls we crash through.
Thursdays came and pocket change would quickly disappear. Upstairs at Lowry's Tavern, we'd pay a nickel for the beer.
Now, when you guys asked me to think of what Zach means to me as a person, as a mocker, and really what makes him unique, there was just one word that kind of got stuck in my head. That's sincerity. And the thing is, with Zach, there's no bullshit. Whether something was good, bad, or anywhere in between, he'd just tell me the truth. And that was refreshing. It really was. But it wasn't just refreshing. It's what caused me to trust him more than anyone else in this program, and that is saying something. Because you guys have become my best of friends. Zach means a lot. He's very easy to trust. It's because of that sincerity that I do. But it's not just a great quality outside the courtroom. On the inside, it's what cost him to win ranks, to win points, to win rounds. You know, I remember when I watched his opening against that Emory team that you guys should have swept pretty handily. My God, it was like when he was giving his opening, it's like he was just sitting inviting these guys over for tea on the back porch. It was crazy. And it's something that I will definitely miss next year. Zach, you were a great mentor, great leader. I think we're all going to miss you next year.
I was breaking hearts and taking names and numbers just for fun, stealing kisses, wishing I was 21.